Hello children, myself Divya Sharma from Shivjyoti Educational Group Kota. Today we will be studying chapter number 17 of your social studies. So take out your books, Getting Ahead in Social Studies, chapter number 17, United Nations, page number 125. Now children, as you know that industrial revolution led to large scale production of goods. We read in the previous chapter that industrial revolution led to large scale production of goods. Hence, the fight to capture more and more Asian and African countries started, because each country wanted to grow its own empire, and fight amongst the industrialized nations started, and millions of soldiers and people were killed. This led to the World War I, which began on 28 July 1914. Now this fight to capture more and more countries led to World War I, which began in 1914. And the First World War ended on 11th November 1918, and millions of soldiers and other people were killed or wounded, and the cities were also completely destroyed. Then what happened? Some countries decided to bring back peace, to restore peace and to prevent wars. So the formation of League of Nations in 1919 came up. In 1919, League of Nations was formed to bring the peace back. But it was a failure. And what were the reasons of the failure of the League of Nations? That many powerful countries did not join the League of Nations. Many powerful countries which were expected to fight again, they did not join the League of Nations, and they did not have any army of its own to maintain the peace. Public was suffering from hunger, disease and other problems. There was a lot of public suffering. This was also one of the reasons of the failure of the League of Nations. The failure of League of Nations brought the World War II, which began on 1st September 1939 and ended on 2nd September 1945. And when it ended in the year 1945, USA dropped two atom bombs on two Japanese cities, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Here you have internal question. So you can write over here on page number 125, you will find. This is your internal question number 1. In which two cities the USA dropped atomic bombs? The answer will be Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Okay, so these were the two cities in which USA dropped the atomic bombs. Now, after seeing lot of destruction caused by the two world wars, the nations of the world came together to find solutions to restore peace and to prevent further wars. And hence, there was the birth of United Nations in the year 1945. This is the symbol of United Nations. Map of the world. In the center, you have this map of the world, which is surrounded by olive branches in white on a blue background. Here you have the blue background and these are olive branches. Olive branches symbolize peace. The symbol came in effect from 28th October 1947. The headquarters of the UN are situated at New York in the United States of America. The headquarters of UN are at New York in United States of America. And the term United Nations was coined by Franklin D. Roosevelt. The term was given by Franklin D. Roosevelt. Now what happened? As a result of there, as many of the nations came forward to find solutions to prevent further wars. So what happened as a result of their efforts, the United Nations was born in the year 1945, and a set of rules was set which was called the Charter of the United Nations. The United Nations officially came into being on 24th October 1945 at San Francisco in the USA. A set of rules which was signed, that was called the Charter of United Nations. Charter means the set of rules and regulations, okay? And it was made at the conference which was held at San Francisco, and it was signed by 50 member countries. October 24, 1945, 50 countries met in San Francisco and agreed to the creation of the new organization, which was called the United Nations. And today, 193 countries are members of the United Nations. The Charter of United Nations was signed by 51 countries. Now we will learn about the aims of the UN. What are the aims of the UN? Maintaining international peace and security. The main aim was to maintain international peace and security, to settle the disputes. The disputes were discussed at the meetings and efforts were made to find more peaceful solutions. Developing friendly relations among the nations. Rather than having disputes among the nations, they tried to develop friendly relations with the other nations. Promoting social progress and better living standards, human rights and basic freedom all over the world, irrespective of caste, color or language. Now it also aimed at promoting the social progress and better living standards of the people. It also promoted the human rights. You will learn some of the human rights. Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted on 10th December 1948. And since then, December 10 is celebrated as the Human Rights Day. Now, some of the human rights are the right to live as free citizens of a country, no discrimination based on sex and religion. Discrimination means difference. Freedom of speech and writing, freedom to travel according to one's choice, the right to education and employment, the right to freedom of worship, equal pay and equal work, equality before the law. These are some of the human rights which are mentioned. Now we will discuss about the principles of the United Nations. You can take out page number 127 of your book, children, under the heading Principles of the United Nations. Okay. Some of the principles are, now the principles are fundamental truth. Okay. All countries that are members of the UN are equal, however developed or underdeveloped they may be. Now in the UN principle states that all the member countries are treated as equals, whether they are developed or underdeveloped countries. All countries that are members of the UN must obey the charter. Now all the member countries which have signed the charter, they should also obey what is written in the charter. What are the rules and regulations? Countries must try to settle their differences by peaceful means rather than fighting having disputes among the countries. They should settle their disputes with the help of peaceful means. The UN will not interfere in the domestic affairs of any country. UN is not going to interfere in the domestic affairs of the particular country. Now the second next topic which we will discuss is the structure of the United Nations. Now I'll discuss the six organs of the UN. First is the General Assembly. It is for making and maintaining rules. Making and maintaining rules. The Security Council is to prevent wars. Security Council is to prevent wars and for security. the secretariat for administration. Secretariat is for administration. Administration and day-to-day work. Then you have the Economic and Social Council, that is for trade, transport and industry. Trade, transport and industry. Then you have the International Court of Justice, which is for stopping fights in future. International Court of Justice is for stopping fights in future. Then you have the Trusteeship Council, which is freeing land which are under the colonial rule. Colonial rule is when the powerful country tries to capture the weaker countries. Okay, so Trusteeship Council is about freeing the land under colonial rule. Freeing land which is under colonial rule. Under colonial rule. Okay, so these are the six organs of the UN. Now I'll discuss them in detail. Okay, you can take out page number 127 of your book. First, I'll discuss the General Assembly. The General Assembly is the main organ of the UN. It is made up of 193 member countries. Here you have your another internal question, children. You can write down the second internal question. Which is the main organ of UN? Question 2, which is the main organ of the UN? The answer will be the General Assembly. The General Assembly. Okay. Each country has one vote. It meets every year. Now the members of the General Assembly meets every year and they have discussions on all the actions of the UN in the General Assembly. And every member country can put forward its ideas and opinions. Every member country can put up its ideas and opinions regarding the discussions which are held in the meeting. And based on the discussions, decisions are taken on what action should be taken. Members decide routine matters with the help of simple majority vote, more than half the votes. Important decisions require a two-thirds majority. However, it is not compulsory for the member nations to follow the recommendations of the General Assembly. Now, the routine matters which are discussed, they are dependent on the simple majority vote, which is more than half votes, and important decisions require at least two-thirds majority votes. And it is not compulsory for the member nations to follow the recommendations, that is suggestions given by the General Assembly. Second organ now we will discuss, that is the Security Council. The Security Council is the most powerful organ of the UN. Security Council is the most powerful organ and General Assembly was the main organ. It is responsible for maintaining international peace and for restoring peace if a war breaks out. It is basically responsible for maintaining the international peace all over the world, and the council meets whenever there is a threat to peace. It may also meet if a nation has a complaint against another nation, and all the member countries have to accept its decision. Now here, as we discuss General Assembly, it meets every year and discusses all topics covered by the UN's charter. Members decide routine matters with a simple majority vote. Security Council, it is the most powerful body of the United Nations. The Council meets whenever there is threat to peace. The Security Council consists of 15 members. Now there are 15 members in the Security Council, out of which you have 5 permanent members. of the Security Council, which are France, Russia, China, United States and United Kingdom. These are the five permanent members of the Security Council. Now, these five permanent members have the power of veto, and veto in Latin language means I forbid. That means they can overrule any majority resolution. So, these five member countries have the power of veto. Now, we'll discuss about the secretariat. The people who work in the UN, that is the staff members, form the secretariat. Now, all the people who are working as staff members, they form the secretariat, and it carries out the day-to-day work of the UN. The head of the secretariat is the Secretary General. Who is the head of the secretariat? He is the Secretary General. And what is the role of Secretary General? He or she carries out the decisions of the Security Council and is a powerful person, and his term is for 5 years, and he is appointed by the General Assembly. The present Secretary General Antonio Guterres assumed the post on 1st January 2017. Now, the present Secretary General is Antonio Guterres. Now, I'll discuss the Economic and the Social Council. This is the picture of the first session of the ECOSOC at the Church House in London, 23rd January 1946. It deals with economic issues like trade, transport, industrialization and social issues, etc. Now, it deals with the economic issues which are related to trade, transport, industrialization means to develop the industries on a very wide scale, and the social issues. And it meets only if the need arises. The members of ECOSOC will meet only if there is a need, and it also looks after the programs related to education, health and culture. Now we'll talk about the International Court of Justice. It is a main judicial organ of the UN. Court consists of 15 judges. The seat of the court is at Hague, Netherlands. Now, judicial organ means related to the judgment of the law, okay? Its main functions are to settle disputes, to provide opinions on legal questions. Now, this is the role of the International Court of Justice. Now, we'll talk about the Trusteeship Council. It makes sure that the people living in these areas get proper education, social and political rights and economic well-being. Now, it serves the purpose that people who are living in the areas, they get the proper education and their social standard of living is also maintained, and their political rights are also protected, and there is economic well-being. Now, we'll talk about the specialized agencies. Now much of the UN's work is carried out by these specialized agencies, and they deal with the food, aid, health and education. Now, first specialized agencies which we are going to talk about is the FAO. It was established on October 16, 1945, and second is UNESCO. UNESCO was established in the year 1946 and its headquarters are in Paris. UNICEF, it was established in the year 1946 and its headquarters are in New York, USA. ILO, which was established in the year 1919 and headquarters are at Geneva, Switzerland. WHO, it was established in the year 1948, headquarters at Geneva, Switzerland. Now, we'll discuss them in detail. Page number 129, if you will see, you will get the special agencies. First is United Nations Children's Fund. It is responsible for the welfare of children all over the world, and it conducts programs especially in developing countries to ensure that the food, health and educational needs of the children are met. Basically, it is responsible for overall welfare of the children. Second is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, that is UNESCO. UNESCO was established by the UN in 1946. Its aim is to encourage nations to work together in the areas of education, science and culture. The UNESCO educates people about health and farming methods, spreading scientific knowledge, teacher training, cultural exchange of students and teachers between the countries. Now, UNESCO aims at encouraging the nations to work together in the fields of education, science and culture. Now, we'll talk about the WHO, that is World Health Organization. It was established in the year 1948 and its aim is to improve the health of the people worldwide, and it provides help and training for health workers to fight against diseases such as malaria, tuberculosis and AIDS. It promotes research in health and medicine. It also provides information about outbreaks of epidemics. WHO aims at improving the health of the people worldwide, and its goal is health for all. Now, next is Food and Agriculture Organization, that is FAO. The main aim of FAO is freedom from hunger for every human in the world. It helps nations to increase food production. It provides them with help in getting better seeds, controlling crop and animal diseases, improving irrigation, conserving soil and forest, etc. FAO aims that no person should remain hungry, and it helps the nation to improve the food production. International Labour Organization, that is ILO, and ILO aims to improve the working conditions and the living standards of the working class. It aims to resolve problems among the government employees and the workers. Now, we'll discuss the achievements of the UN. What are the achievements of the UN? The United Nations has tried to prevent tension or war between countries. As UNO was established to prevent future wars, so it has tried to prevent tension and war between the countries. It has been largely successful in its efforts, and it has also been successful. How? Wars between India and Pakistan, Iran and Iraq, Israel and Palestine, North and South Korea and many others were not allowed to grow bigger, mainly because of the efforts of United Nations. The UN has also played an important part in arms control, especially in preventing the use of nuclear weapons. Nuclear weapons are like bombs and missiles which are used. The UN has been very successful in its fight against poverty, that is extremely poor, disease and illiteracy. It has also achieved success in improving cultural cooperation among the countries. These are some of the achievements which we are learning, children of the UN. However, people in the developing world feel that the UN does not understand the problems of the developing nations, but it is still believed that UN does not understands the problem of the developing nations, and therefore it is unable to solve their problems and could not prevent the invasion of Iraq by the American-led armed forces, nor put an end to the war in Darfur, Sudan. Some people have also questioned the veto power which is enjoyed by the five member countries, permanent member countries. Now, we will discuss about India's contribution to the United Nations. India has been a member of the United Nations since it was formed in 1945. It has always stood for peace and played an important role in the UN's efforts for world peace. It has always played a major role in maintaining peace. Some of the main achievements and efforts of India are as follows. Indian armed forces have been used as peacekeeping forces in the Middle East, Cyprus and the Democratic Republic of Congo and Sudan. Now, Indian peacekeeping armed forces have been used as the peacekeeping forces. India is not a permanent member of UN Security Council. However, India has been elected several times for the seat of Security Council, that is for the year 1984-85 and 1991-92. India has also played a prominent role, prominent means important, in putting forward the concerns of developing countries at the United Nations. It has actively opposed the policy of considering blacks as inferior. Inferior over here refers to lower in rank. Blacks as inferior to the whites in South Africa. In South Africa, the blacks were considered as inferior to the whites. So, it has opposed the policy. This policy was known as apartheid. Finally, due to the pressures of the United Nations and countries like India, apartheid was abolished in South Africa. Due to the pressures and the efforts of the UN, the policy of apartheid was totally abolished from South Africa, and India established relations with the South Africa only after this. Many Indians are working in the UN agencies. India has also received help from time to time from the agencies for its development programs. Now, many Indians are also working for the UN agencies, and they are timely receiving help for their development programs. Children, this was all about the explanation of the chapter. We will be discussing the book work and the copy work. So, first is question number A, that is, match the special agency of the UN with its aim. Welfare of the children of the world, that is responsible, UNICEF is responsible. Freedom from hunger, FAO. Promotion of education, science and culture, UNESCO. Improve conditions of the working class, ILO. Improve health of the people, that is WHO. Second question is, you have to write true and false for the sentences. The only aim of UN is to prevent wars, that is false. All nations are members of the Security Council, the statement is false. The General Assembly is the most powerful organ of the UN, that is false, it is the main organ. There have been no wars between nations after the UN was formed, it is also false. India has never had a seat in the Security Council, this statement is false. Now we will discuss the multiple choice questions. A set of rules according to which the UN is governed is called the Charter of the United Nations. Which of these is not an aim of the UN? To govern and rule newly formed nations. In the General Assembly, all countries have one vote. The most powerful organ of the UN is the Security Council. The agency of the UN that is responsible for the welfare of children all over the world is the UNICEF. Which country followed the policy of apartheid? That is South Africa. This was the book work. Now we'll switch on to copy work. Answer the following questions. Why was the United Nations formed? The two world wars left many nations destroyed and millions killed or wounded. So, the nations of the world came forward to form the United Nations, that is UN, whose main aim was to prevent future wars. As we read that the two world wars caused lot of destruction and millions of people were killed or wounded. So, some of the nations came forward to restore peace, and hence UN was established in the year 1945. Besides maintaining world peace, in what other ways does the UN help its member countries? UN helps its member countries by developing friendly relations between nations, in solving economic and social problems, to fight with diseases and preserve the environment, to encourage respect and freedom of all the people. Except maintaining the world peace, these are the other ways in which the UN helps its member countries. Who is the head of the UN? List his or her main responsibilities. The head of the UN is the Secretary General. He or she oversees the day-to-day work of the UN and also carries out the decisions taken by the Security Council. As you read that the head of the UN is the Secretary General and he sees the day-to-day work of the UN and carries out decisions which are taken by the Security Council. What is apartheid? Why did India oppose it? Apartheid is the policy of treating blacks as inferior, who are inferior to the whites. The Indian government opposed this policy since it holds that no human being must be considered inferior or superior due to the color of skin. Now, as we read that the policy of apartheid, which says that blacks were treated inferior as compared to the whites, but the Indian government opposed this policy as it considers that no human being should be considered inferior or superior due to the color of the skin. Question number 5 is, what do you mean by specialized agencies of the UN? Name the 4 agencies of the UN. Specialized agencies are agencies that run programs dealing with food, working conditions, health, education and the environment and agriculture of its member countries. And the 4 specialized agencies are WHO, FAO, ILO and UNICEF. Name the 6 organs of the UN. Which organ is the most powerful? 6 organs of the UN are the General Assembly, the Security Council, the Secretariat, the Economic and Social Council, the International Court of Justice, the Trusteeship Council, and which organ is the most powerful? The Security Council is the most powerful organ. Name the 5 permanent members of the Security Council. The 5 permanent members of the Security Council are USA, United Kingdom, France, Russia, and China. So this was all about the bookwork and copywork, children. Do it very neatly and also watch the video again. Thank you.